two dancers for flute and piano. I say two dancers, but they're actually extensions of two old dance forms, which are the saraband, a rather slow and solemn Spanish dance, and the gigue, which is a polite French version of the Irish jig. Now, Keith is a very experienced composer. He goes deep, he's subtle, he is rather reserved, and he doesn't wear his heart on a sleeve, but that would be a messy thing to do. So, what we have is not just a straightforward saraband and a straightforward gigue, but very much elaborations in Keith's own individual and deeply searching style.
Thank you.
quite like it. Before I invite comments, one observation of my own. I don't know if you've noticed, but the two dances ended in a completely different way. The saraband, which is a slow dance to begin with, loses momentum at the end and just fades away gently as the music gets slower. The jig is completely different, or jig. That really builds up momentum all through the piece. And if anything, the momentum gets faster at the end, and so the piece rushes towards a kind of car crash on the final chord. So, two interesting... Well, I don't know how else to put it. I'm trying to bring across the point that two pieces end in two very different ways, which makes them such an interesting pair. Right, comments on the saraband and the jig.
Beautiful writing for the flute register, just right, it covered the perfect range of it, and they make a lovely pair to go together with the performance.
Yes, I must, you wouldn't realise that...
A lovely performance.
Yes, thank you. Well done, Townsend. We are lucky to have tutors in the school who can do more than one thing and do it well. Other comments? Ben.
I didn't realise it because we didn't hear the flute until tonight in the classes. But hearing it with the flute, the saraband, reminded me a lot of Debussy.
Interesting point. The same thought crossed my mind. There is more than a touch of French impressionistic music about what Keith has written. Now, Keith doesn't normally work in quite that style. French impressionism was music going from about the 1890s through to just before the Second World War. Sorry, I saw another hand up, but I didn't see who it was. Oh, yes.
I was
going to
say that the second dance, it could have been a final leap at the finish.
Leap?
Yes, spectacular leap
and
the end.
Yes, I agree with that. Perhaps the word leap is a bit less pungent than the term car crash. Well, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to imply that.
For those of us who have spent our youth dancing jigs, a jig will take you to heaven, not to a car crash.
It probably depends on how much you drink during the evening.
Well, it's so horror-toxy, such an intoxicating word.
You get the chance later.
Any other comments? And did anyone not like the music? No? Well,
one of the things that occurred to me, strongest about Keith, was that we all know how many bars a sequence of the jig takes.
Yes.
But it wasn't clear from any of the other pieces, the dances that they were doing. When if you're writing a tune or a melody for a dance, then you should take account of how many bars the sequence of the dance takes. So the people are actually dancing can be like to have the music moves.
But as I said, there's quite a lot of music which is dancing without being actual dance music. And this is the kind of thing Keith wrote. I don't think Keith had any intention of writing music for dancers. Is that right, Keith? So, do I see any other hands, any other comments?
I would say that he's taken that on to another level.
Yes.
An artistic thought. And it worked really well with that sort of early 20th century French feel.
Yes.
And the harmony was beautiful.
Yes, I mean, Keith is a deep composer. He goes into regions that other people never reach.
Well, the music he played last year, the variations, was super and was one that, and that's not from a different play again. Very wide range, well done, Keith. Well done.
So the first piece, the saraband, I didn't think I'd written it at all. I thought I'd pinched it from somewhere. It just sort of came.
Well, I can't say I recognised it as a take on anyone else's music. Joyce.
Andy Bosch, there's tango had in there.
Jesus, I don't know. Well, Joyce, what's the answer to that? You'll have to go to Zoxide, Bars and Brothels to play the tables. I wish you'd do it. Right, anyway, I don't want to. Now, listen. chancing their arm on next year's composition course. Thank you. Oh, you
have one question. What is next year's theme?
Death is still germinating in my little mind. I don't have much of a mind. I just have several brain cells connected by cobwebs. A possibility I'm thinking about would in fact be two different themes. For purposes of composition, we would be exploring the idea of pure melody. So in this case, not dance music, not accompaniment, but seeing how melody itself works. So with a remit like that, people could write completely unaccompanied music like the old medieval plain chant. But I'm also thinking of a second theme, purely for purposes of discussion with the class, which will be looking at choral music, the writing of choral music. Now, Ben in particular writes a lot of choral music, and other people might want to chance around that as well. But I repeat, this is something I'm still turning over in my mind. I've yet to discuss it with the other composers. So what I've just said is highly provisional. Right. So thank